2017 Brickell Borough Sanitary Sewer Contract C, CCTV inspection. Bids were advertised and publicly opened on Friday, December 9th, 2016, at 10 a.m. in the council chambers for the 2017 Brickell Borough Sanitary Sewer Contract C. An inspection of the following bid results. Motion of the borough, I'm sorry, AAA flexible pipe, 10% bid bond, amended yes, $71,289.50. State pipe services, 10% bid bond, amended yes, bid of $71,470.25. Inside pipe, 10% bid bond, amended yes, $77,296. And Robinson pipe cleaning, 10% bid bond, amended yes, at a bid of $126,359. Motion of borough council regarding the award of the bid to the lowest responsible bidder, AAA flexible pipe, in the amount of $71,289.50, contingent upon review of all required documentation by engineer sites.
I'll second.
All right, Bruce and Bill, any discussion? Pat?
Yes, please. I would ask the council reject this contract. Newer camera technology is available. That newer technology handles laterals and main lines. This contract would represent a waste of $71,000 taxpayer dollars. I understand that we have an operations and maintenance plan for our sewer system. But that operations and maintenance plan does not take into account newer camera technology that is available. It is some amazing stuff, okay? That they can not only look at the main line, but that they can look at laterals as well. In order to incorporate that additional scope, it is going to take some time for the borough to look at laterals, how they want to deal with the main lines, and what kind of bid specifications need to be done. Yes, it would be pushing off the video inspections until late 2017, early 2018. But it is much better to do that than to waste $71,000 taxpayer dollars on doing something that can wait a bit. We have cambered our entire community. I'll bet some of it is as old as 1994. I am not opposed to cambering. I just think we should make use of the newer technology. Other point, the older camera technology, they clean the line before they set the camera through. This newer camera technology, Dormont Borough, found that they could send the camera through and then decide to clean. They saved 80% of their cleaning budget. Okay? So not only the camera, the cleaning budget can be reduced. I would ask you to please reject these bids, save these taxpayer dollars.
President, can we ask the engineer's opinion on this?
Absolutely.
You know, in reviewing this information, there are certain requirements that we're supposed to follow relative to the O&M plan that's in place relative to the consent decree. We're required to videotape any sewer that is greater than 8 inches every 5 years. And we're required to videotape any sewer that is 8 inches or less once every 10 years. We have some videotape that is old as 1994 on some of these sewers. I'm not gonna make any excuses as to why it wasn't videotaped, but I think it was just a matter of something, a few of these segments slipped through the cracks. Last year, we did not do any videotaping of the sewer system in the borough because all of the efforts and budgets that was established was put forth to make repairs on Washington Avenue in conjunction with the work that PennDOT and Pennsylvania American Water did to make upgrades and improvements to Washington Avenue between St. Clair Street, excuse me, and Chartier Street. So we spent a considerable amount of money there. That was, you know, all part of the O&M plan, but, you know, we had to seize the moment to take care of that work. There's other, so since all the work was focused on one segment of pipe last year, the other segments of the pipe in the borough did not get any work done on. The video, the CCTV work that we're performing is to take care of 2016 and 2017 to be in compliance with the O&M plan with regards to the DEP requirements. I think if we defer doing anything, we have 3 years worth of videotaping to do. And the other thing is, you know, we take this information from the CCTV inspection and review it, and if there are level four, level five, based on the NASCO coding system that's in place, those are the ones we put in the upcoming year's repair contract. As I may have said in the past to many of you here on council, I'll repeat it again. While we have the contractor in town doing this CCTV work, we make it very clear to them at a pre-construction meeting that if you find any level four, level five defects that may have a serious implication of resulting in a backup or a flooding of sewage into someone's home, let us know immediately while we have our contractor in town who's doing the other repairs, so that we can save money and have him do that work, as I often call it, the proverbial 3 o'clock Friday afternoon repair. We don't want to have those repairs. Doing this preventative O&M maintenance prevents us from having those emergencies. Will we have emergencies? Yes, we still have, but we're trying to minimize them. So the TV of the sewer inspection is required. We're required to make the repairs. The lining of the sewers, that can be delayed a year until we get caught up with other things. So I would suggest we move forward. With regards to looking at people's laterals, I think that the borough has to put a good forth effort if they so desire to inspect people's laterals. I know there's other communities who have lateral inspection ordinances in place, and I think it would behoove us to probably get some examples of those, not only of our local communities like South Bay and Calder, but, you know, other communities at Gateway Road. I can get us examples of their ordinances. So I think, you know, we have a lot, you know, big task ahead of us with regards to the inspection of the laterals. That's something that I think the DEP and the local government at the county level would like to see us do, maybe as a demonstration project. And I think we should use 2017 as a time to embrace and work on the lateral ordinance.
So the example of that would be if they were selling it?
Yes, that could do that. Another thing could be that we could maybe take the borough and break it up into zones. Maybe we break it up into 5 or 8 zones or districts, and we do the laterals in those districts. Maybe we do that as part of the, you know, the, like I said before, the 5 and the 10 year cycle. So,
Joe, what you're suggesting is upon closing, prior to closing,
that's really good.
They've done that too.
So, I mean, there's some options out there on how we want to handle this.
Okay.
Well, I would say I object the idea that that's waste.
Right. And
I think that the plan that is in place is a good idea for our community.
Question on the motion.
Mr. Sykes?
Yes.
The place where we agree is in perhaps dividing us and taking and doing the town in a matter of zones and perhaps doing some inspections as we're going through, and that we need time to look at this, how best to implement it. Councilman Henderson?
Yes.
The reason that I believe it is a waste of taxpayer dollars is because when you camera both the main line and the lateral, which, as the engineer pointed out, we see this requirement coming down, okay? If our plan in 2018 is to camera both the laterals and the main lines in a section of our community, if we change, because that operations and maintenance requirement is a requirement we established as a community. That's our plan that was designed by our engineer and passed by our council. Not external. Am I correct in that?
You are correct, Pat, in the fact that it's not an externally approved, but let me finish first, okay? We prepared the O&M plan. It was reviewed by the DEP and it was implemented, okay? The O&M plan is often up for audits. It is also up for making improvements to it so that as we move forward with the plan, it's an evolving systematic way of operating and maintaining the sanitary sewer system. So, you know, I think there's no mandate to do lateral testing at this time?
No.
So, you know, let's work on getting something in place, and if someone forces our hand to do it, we're already there.
Yeah, and that's, the vast majority of the communities have not pulled the trigger on that.
Right.
The regulators have highly suggested that they would like that as one of the menu items on your round of things to do. And this round of things in terms that not just our engineering firm, but firms across and communities across the county have, at least in this round, discovered for that demonstration project purposes, they were coming up with things that were better bang for the buck in the short term than the lateral testing. There's many reasons to proceed in one way or another way, or at one time or another time with those. I think the manager and the engineer and I and Kate were happy to sit with you guys in the war and continue to talk those sorts of things through. But I see the lateral thing, I think, like Joe and Lori, is a separate thing from what we are ongoing. You know, how to and whether to and the timing of the whole lateral testing program is part of your future is a valid topic, but a separate topic from the immediate. Certainly this contract letting for the purposes of helping Joe and Lori to keep up on the ongoing consent decree requirements that they continuously balance off or not.
We have more repairs than we have money for. And before we keep up with looking for repairs, there are more things that we can fix on the list already. Again, Mr. Anderson, the reason I look at this as a waste is because as we move forward and we have to go to do something with the laterals, or for that matter, as Alcosan comes in and moves forward and done something with the laterals, the money, the $71,000 that we spend today to camera main lines would be a byproduct of a proper cameraing that would be done in 2018 with the laterals included. Remember, the camera that they work with is called a LAMP, a lateral and maintenance probe. Okay? The reason they call it lateral and main, I'm sorry, not lateral and maintenance, lateral and mainline probe, is because it cameras both the lateral and the mainline at the same time. That's why they're somewhat together.
I watched it. I saw the video, and I love the technology. It's a great concept, but I don't think it's not here right now. The concept is here.
It's been out there since 2014.
We're not prepared to implement it here.
As a community, we're not prepared for it. And that's why I'm saying reject these bids today, get prepared for it, and let something out in 2018 that is going to wisely use that $71,000.
Let me clarify one thing for you guys, just for discussion's sake. And I think Joe indicated there is two ways, more than two ways, but two little ways that you could implement a lateral testing program is either the more prominently used time of sale ordinances, which is the same as your dye testing.
Right.
That's what is slowly but surely coming into vogue. Right. In South Bay at different places, a handful of places, and probably will be coming to a neighborhood near you elsewhere as this thing progresses. That's different from doing a program where you say, like Joe said, okay, we're going to take sectors and break them up and then systematically go in, not at time of sale, but just independently get the data, and then I assume force folks to do things as they enter. Yeah, when all I...
Wait a minute, what do you mean by that?
Well, that's the other shoe that drops.
Hold on, so Joe, if something needs to be done, what happens?
Well, I think that's where, if it's discovered, if we take the borough and break it up into zones, and you find that something has to be done with that ladder on somebody's home, you need to have the mechanism in place to tell them, first of all, you have to make the repairs to this lateral, so it's a watertight system. And second of all, here's the time frame in which you have to complete the work. And third thing, if you don't do the work within the specified time frame, you're going to be there's going to be fines and penalties for your incompletion of it. So that's, you know, it's something, it has to be done. I mean, the point of sale, that puts a burden on the seller. But...
Which is just like your other, your
dye test. Your dye test, right. So it
sounds more expensive than a dye test.
Basically, the same thing you went through in the early 90s, late 80s, early 90s.
Right.
With the stormwater, removing the stormwater from...
Correct.
And we did that back then, broke it up into different sections in the borough. You're going to be doing the same thing with the laterals as far as inspecting them.
If you did it on a sector approach that.
That's if you go that way. And back then, I remember in the late 80s, there was such an outcry because it was being done, but we were mandated to do it. So we had to pick it up in the 90s and go in and do it. And we worked with several people that had systems, they had put pumps in and everything else. But it was a bullet that had to be bitten at the time, and it did. And that's the same thing we're going to be confronted with in the future. But you go to tell somebody they got to spend $30,000 to dig your sores up from the house out, you better be prepared. So,
and there's no, right now we're not mandated to do it, so it'd be a little hard to tell someone
to do something they don't have to do.
Right, and the regulators haven't met. I mean, the regulators may offer some assistance, who knows?
Well, yes, and they may end up, technically right now, the laterals are private, our public lives, are our public lives that we're responsible for. It may be that when they start, the due diligence is being done right now on a massive scale to figure out what the kind of next phase of this consent decree is. There may be, and help me out, Joe, there may be a design where they end up saying, you know what, if you look at it as one big plumbing system from here all the way down to Alcosan and everything in between, they may come up with one plan where it's, what we call like crap and trade, where you end up fixing bigger parts of your plumbing system. You know it's leaking here, you know it's leaking there, you know it's leaking everywhere, but you get a bigger bang for the buck if you can fix this portion of your toilet, so to speak, okay? That may be and end up where some communities go. That is why, actually, some have kind of held back on getting full steam into that or this or this fix or the other, because we're really still doing the due diligence, and for the next, year or so, it's going to kind of have that other shoe drop. You're really not bending the arc that much on the lab, on your flow reduction, whether something happens this year or next year or 2 years, because on the time of sale ordinance, it is a kind of slow drip fix. It's slowly over time as properties flip that, happens.
So the main goal of this is to stop the infiltration of water into the sewer system.
Correct.
It's not sanitary sewer liquids getting into the ground. It's basically rainwater and water getting into the sewer system. That's the main purpose. It's not like we're going out there going, there's a health hazard or anything. It's taking out the infiltration of water. So just so that people don't think we're overlooking sanitary sewer problems as far as that.
And it's not to say that there's technology out there that can correct these laterals. I mean, if the lateral is intact and in good shape, you can put a liner in it. I think they call it a top hat liner, where the machine comes through there, puts the liner in, and then floats it into the lateral. And I think we had them in one day, and I think they can go 150 or 200 feet with this high top liner, and then you line the main one too. So there's other ways to do it.
We are lining the main lines, and we are doing all that.
We're
we're not doing any alarming this year.
No, but I'm saying we're going to.
We've been doing it.
Yes.
There's also a thought that as more communities get into it, they're following the three or jumping into the voter majority of the 83 at one time, there's going to possibly be more pressure for the remedial help that comes with it from different sources and whatnot. And having said that, the vast majority have implemented, whether it's now, a year from now, 2 years from now, 3 years from now, most have done time of sale type models, not kind of like sector type models. So back to your point today, I don't believe you're probably pushing down the road more than you'd be doing anyway, because that's probably going to be too simple on the tracks.
As you can see from the discussion here, there's a lot of unknowns about how laterals and main lines would be tested or videoed going forward, which is again why I suggest that you reject this work.
We're not prepared to do laterals right now. We're going to stay with our plan and continue.
I understand what you're planning on doing. I am asking you to go down a different course, to delay that until you can incorporate all of the information you've discussed here tonight into a plan that takes into account that new technology, that newer technology, all of what you've discussed. And by the way, you have lots of work to do. He just rejected the lining contract because you didn't have enough money. There's a lot of work you can do without having to go down a path of cambering just main lines. I'd throw one last piece out. Alcasan has been talking about regionalization of interceptor lines. I noticed something. Alcasan came down and recambered all of the line that goes from point C5310 up to south of the village. We had just cambered that. They completely redid it. Am I incorrect in this? Did they not?
We cambered it and cleaned it because we were getting back up into the home. So
yes.
It had to be done.
It had to be done. But they came in a year later or 2 years later and recambered the whole thing because that's what they wanted to do as part of their regionalization. I come back to the same thing. If we reject these bids, if we reject this contract, it doesn't mean that we give us time to figure out a better way of accomplishing the goal of not having our overflows. So, and what would be the consequence of that?
We don't know. I don't think we want to find out.
Can we modify our operations?
You can't, right? You can't modify the cater.
Go ahead. I've made it as passionate an argument as I can make for not doing this as I can.
All right. There's a motion, a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Comcast cable franchise. Do you also have any business? Yep. One thing real quick. If you guys can look at your schedule between now and our next meeting. We have another meeting. We've been talking about a lot of stuff at the end of last year, this year with the laterals, kind of like go over our 2017 plan, what we want to implement and try to get in for next year. So at the end of the next year, we're not saying, hey, let's try to push this in and try to do that. We already have a great plan. So kind of go out, find a date, we'll advertise the meeting.
Do you want a workshop?
Under his committee of planning for next year, he put together.
Everybody.
I make a motion we have that.
All right.
Second.
Aye.